Hey folks, if you've driven down North or South Railway Street since Sunday, I'm sure you've seen that there's a picket line there. CP rail workers picketing because there was some negotiations going on. Those negotiations broke down. The workers say they're not getting what they want, so they've gone to the picket line. I went down to the local Legion where the union, the Teamsters, normally have their union meetings, and the Legion let them use that space to organize their picketing. And I spoke with Ron Peters, who's the picketing captain down there right now, to get their take on what's going on and why they're out there picketing.
This is our strike headquarters. CP Rail locked us out, and we went on strike right after they locked us out in order to protect our collective agreement.
Real quick, big thanks to the sponsors. I want to thank Hemptown Rock and Downtown Medicine Hat. Patty has a wonderful little artisanal cannabis store, fully licensed by the AGLC, and you need to be 18 years of age or older to go in there and buy cannabis. Gas King. One of the best resources we have in Medicine Hat right now because the price of gas has gone up a lot, and all you got to do is get your Gas King card, and with that King card, you'll save 6 cents per liter at the pump, and everybody needs that right now. Hey, have you been charged with something, accused of something? That happens sometimes. You need good representation. I recommend my lawyer, Lyndon Heidinger. Animal World, that's where I get my food for Kahlua the cat. Truckers, 24/7 restaurant, that's where I get some food for me. And of course, Gold Dust Jewelry. Johan at Gold Dust Jewelry can make you any custom piece or repair the jewelry that needs fixing. And my friend Trevor over at 24/7 Rideshare, download the app right now. It's just like Uber for Medicine Hat. You'll get a ride and you'll know how much it costs before you leave.
This isn't what anybody wants, is it?
No, absolutely not. They're still in the process of negotiating, and hopefully it comes to an end sooner than later. Mm-hmm. We got to take a stand when the stand is taken.
Mm-hmm. So we see people that are walking up and down right next to the, you know, the famous railway in Medicine Hat. They've got their Teamster signs out. What do the signs mean, and why are those people out there right now?
We're out here for our benefits, and we're out here for our pensions, mostly the pensions. Mm-hmm. You know, we make pretty good money. A raise is always nice, but it's about our pensions, and CP is not funding our pension as they should be. Mm-hmm. They've had a little bit of a holiday from it because our pension is basically funding itself. Mm-hmm. And you know, we ask for a little bit extra, and they don't have any money, but, you know, they can buy Kansas City Southern and lots of money there. It hurts. You know, there's a lot of people here who spend a lot of time. Like, the work is hard, but it's what we give up to do the work. We miss weddings. We miss funerals. Well, funerals maybe not so much. But we can't just say, you know, your cousin's getting married next week, can you be there? No, like, this is stuff that's got to be planned out.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, your kid's birthday is on, you know, next Friday. Well, am I going to be here next Friday in order to get to go to my kid's birthday? We can manipulate it a little bit.
Yeah.
But when it's all said and done, you got to be pretty lucky sometimes to get the time off.
There's a lot more surprise days on than there are surprise days off, it sounds like.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah. It's, you know, you think you're going to work at, you know, say 11 o'clock at night, so you go to bed early, and all of a sudden the phone doesn't ring to go to work at 11, it goes to ring at 7 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
You know, which is a bonus, you get all night in bed. But exact opposite.
That's a bonus. Sounds scary to me.
Well, the exact opposite occurs. You don't think you're going to work till 7 o'clock in the morning, so you stay up and, you know, do your normal everyday life stuff.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden the phone's ringing at 11 o'clock at night to go to work. Well, you've been up all day, and now it's time to go to work. So you got to be careful that way.
Yeah.
I think we're on bulletin 12 right now that the union has put out for us since. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure when the first one come out, and as time's going on, they're getting a little bit more fast.
12 bulletins since the lockout?
No.
Or just during the negotiations?
During the negotiations.
Gotcha. Like, so over the past couple weeks?
Even back to pre-2022.
When, oh, okay. Gotcha. Yeah.
You know, this is kind of what we're asking for. This is what the company's asking for. And,
yeah.
And it just goes on from there. And we're up to number 12 right now. So...
So these people that are out there that are on the picket line that are walking around are privy to what's going on. They know how it affects their life. They know how it's going to affect their bottom line. They know what they want, and they know that it's possible to get, and that's why they're out there, I guess.
Yeah. And I think for the most part, they're all pretty well informed.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we send out a mass email, you know, stating, okay, well, here's bulletin 10, here's mm-hmm. bulletin 11. The local executive guys, like from the conductors, the trainmen, and the engineers.
And I see, so what you're doing today is basically just keeping tabs everybody who's here and doing picketing? Is that the job today?
Yeah. We're all supposed to come down. We're picketing daily. And, you know, we kind of decided on, you know, 3 hours at a time.
Okay.
And, you know, we only... have to do one, but we highly encourage, you know, guys, if they can, to do more than one a day, just to keep more people on the picket line.
Well, it sounds like the people that have come through here and stuff like that, that's nothing to them.
No, you know, when you're used to working, you know, 10, 12 hours a day.
And it just happens to be a beautiful day out today.
Well, it was a better turnout today than what it was yesterday.
Yeah.
You know, you had to have your
hat. It's a little brisk. Yeah.
You had to have your hat tied on pretty tight.
Yeah. What's the main message that you want to tell people of Medicine Hat that are driving by, that see the picket signs, it says Teamsters? What do you want them to know?
I want them to know that not only are we here for us and to protect us, but just about everything that any person has working nowadays has been fought for by a union, whether they're unionized or not. Holidays, minimum wage, child labor laws, it's all been unions that have gotten all of this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we're out here striking right now to better us, which in turns betters everybody, mm-hmm. whether they're unionized or not.
Right on. If I do get a hold of anybody from CP, what's the top question I should ask them?
Oh, that's a tough one.
Seems like a money question for them, right? I mean, it's like when you're posting billions of dollars in profits, why can't you give these guys that are working hard just the basic... I mean, things cost more, right? I mean, everything, the gas. I mean, just look at gas alone. They should give you a raise just when gas goes up.
Well, exactly. It's, you know, they come out with what they figure is a fair pay increase. And, you know, that doesn't even touch the inflation over the last month,
right?
Like, with the way gas has gone. Happy employees are hardworking employees.
Yeah.
And I don't think that we're asking for too much. They obviously think that we are, but you know, if you pay guys a little bit more, or you know, maybe concede here and there, they're more likely to work a little bit harder, and hopefully they'll come to an agreement. Sooner the better.
They usually do. Historically, you guys have been successful, right?
As a group. Yes, I think we have. We maybe not always get everything that we want for.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, with a conservative government, it's a little bit more difficult because they're very pro, what's the word, company, money.
Mm-hmm.
With the Liberals and by themselves, maybe not so much, but with the NDP backing them, and the NDP is very pro-labor. You know, it helps us out, you know, maybe get to work with the company better before somebody says, yeah, we're forcing you back to work, and we're no further ahead, we're no further behind, and it's just back to the status quo. It's very, it's hard on the guys.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when the company is going to say, okay, or when the government is going to say that, we're just going to force you back to work. It's disheartening.
Yeah.
Like, what's the point of us even doing this? And that's the way it was two strikes ago. You know, Lisa Raitt had the, we're going to legislate you back to work before we even went on strike.
Mm.
And the last one, Trudeau said he wasn't sticking his nose in our business, and 18 hours later we had a contract. So was it a good contract for the company? I don't know. I thought it was a fairly good contract for us.